Now, the character of Candy is a really interesting and very poignant figure. In other words, he's a really important but yet melancholic, a very sad character that Steinbeck used. Now, he's the only old ranch worker on the farm. However, his character is used by Steinbeck to essentially show just how brutal the capitalist order really is. People such as Candy are basically used, their life force is taken out of them, they're used in their prime years, but then once the ranch is finished with them, once they're too old to give any more labor back, they are basically discarded, okay? So essentially, you want to talk about Candy and the quotations that you want to memorize in regards to Candy's character. You want to think about it in terms of how he illustrates the brutality of life on the ranch, and by extension, the brutality of life in what Steinbeck sometimes saw as a very brutal capitalist American society. Now, as you can see behind me, there's key quotations to remember and, of course, word level analysis you want to do with these quotations. Now, the first quotation actually relates to Candy's dog. But really, to be honest, when you think about how Candy's dog is described, the dog is basically an extension of Candy himself. The dog is used as a metaphor and a symbol of Candy himself. Now, the dog is described as grey of muzzle, ellipsis, moth-eaten. The word level analysis you want to do here, first off, is the adjective grey. Just like the dog is grey, Candy himself is grey. Also, you want to think about the alliteration of M, muzzle and moth, and of course, moth-eaten. It's been eaten away by years. Even if the dog has been such a loyal dog on the farm, actually, ultimately, the farm workers and the ranch workers kind of look at it with disdain and ultimately want to kill it. It's been basically used up and now it's going to be shot dead. And perhaps this could foreshadow. So maybe, for instance, if Mice and Men, the novella, carried on, and if there was a part two, part three, part four sequel, perhaps we could very well see that Candy ultimately will also face the same fate as his dog. Maybe he's not going to be shot dead, but perhaps him being kicked off the ranch in his old age, that basically signals his death. He won't be able to find work elsewhere, and ultimately he's going to die a very lonely, miserable death. So basically the dog's life and its path basically echoes the life and the path of older ranch workers when they were no longer useful on the ranch, just like how old people in capitalist society in America during the time, when they're no longer useful, they're basically just cast aside, okay? The second quotation relating to Candy's character is, once all the men on the ranch basically leave and they are in the brothel, so basically they are with prostitutes, and the key characters that are left behind are, of course, Candy, Crooks, Lenny, and Curly's wife. Now, Candy tells Crooks, nobody would listen to us. And here, the word level analysis you want to focus on is the pronoun us. Of course, he's talking to Crooks. Candy is the only old man. Crooks is the only black African-American man on the ranch. Both of them realize the unique struggles that they face as outsiders and how actually all the other ranch workers really don't see them as worthy of even listening or believing in them, okay? And of course, what this is illustrating is just the abject brutality that society treats older people like Candy in that kind of disregarding way. And of course, obviously by extension, it also treats people like Crooks as an outsider in a very brutal manner. The third quotation to remember for Candy's character is when it comes to how he tries to defend his dog from its death, okay? And he looks to everybody and he's trying to get Slim, please, Slim, spare my dog. And of course, the dog is still killed, okay? And the quotation here is, Candy looked from help from face to face. And here, the word level analysis you want to focus on is a repetition of the word face, from face to face. Even actually, you can mention alliteration from and face, alliteration of F, yeah? Now, here, with regards to this quotation is really, really powerful to show just the brutality of this system that chews up people like Candy, ranch workers, even like Slim, because once Slim gets old and he's no longer useful on the ranch right now, in the novella, he's quite powerful and therefore he's very useful. But once he becomes old, he's going to face the same fate as Candy, right? And nobody will look to him for help. Nobody will come to his rescue. And this, obviously, this quotation illustrates how Candy is alone. He stands as an old man and everyone doesn't really care for his say. And of course, they end up killing the dog. The other quotation to remember for his character is when he states, when he confesses and he realizes that he's not very useful anymore on the ranch. He states, I ain't much good. And here you want to focus on the modal verb ain't. Remember, modal verbs are verbs that don't necessarily show an action. Can, will, must, will. All of these modal verbs, for instance, they tend to go with another verb and they usually emphasize a state of being, a belief even. And of course, the modal verb here ain't I am not, illustrates Candy's belief that, and his internalized belief that, as an old man, he really is useless in society, which obviously, as readers, makes us feel a lot of pathos, a lot of sadness and empathy for him. The other quotation to remember for Candy's character is when he realizes that George and Lenny have this American dream, this dream of owning a farm, and he basically says he has some savings, and now coupled with the money that George and Lenny are going to earn plus Candy's savings, this dream of owning a farm is actually potentially going to be realized. This description is really powerful. They looked at one another, comma, amazed, full stop. This thing they had never really believed in was coming true. So Candy stepping in with George and Lenny to say, let's all work together as a community rather than being as individuals. We have strength in numbers. Let's put money together and put money towards this farm. This dream, which is just an idea, actually now becomes a reality. They all realize and it dawns on them that they might actually have a chance at getting a shot of the American dream. Now, the key word level analysis you want to do with this quotation is a bit of a long quotation, okay? Now, the first is you want to focus on the pronoun they. This is a collective pronoun. Always remember that one of the things that Steinbeck wanted to illustrate in Of Mice and Men is just how solitary and lonely life for migrant laborers is. But actually also he's illustrating here through this collective pronoun as a group that in a community, migrant laborers actually find strength. They can actually escape the rat race, okay? And of course here, this collective pronoun shows that them working together, George, Lenny and Candy, is going to give them the possibility, the one shot that they have at owning land and attaining the American dream. The other word level analysis you want to do here is the assonance of A, so another amazed. And of course, this assonance illustrates just how they've realized that this dream is within their reach. They can actually attain this American dream. The other word level analysis you want to do is alliteration of T, this thing, they, and true. And finally, the adverb really and the verb believed, okay? And of course, this the adverb especially and the verb really believed shows that these men subconsciously believed that something like getting and attaining an American dream, something like attaining any ownership of a farm, they had subconsciously believed that it was for other people who are more lucky, but now they're starting to realize that they might themselves have a shot at this. And of course, this realization comes because Candy throws in his lot with George and Lenny and therefore makes the possibility of them having enough money to own the farm a reality, okay? So those are the key quotations to remember when it comes to Candy's character and the word level analysis that you should do. So make sure you try and memorize these quotations.